I'm delighted to be here. This is my favourite festival, place where everyone's open to strangeness and weird ideas, and we feel really at home here. Aaaaaah is a dystopian horror comedy where there's no dialogue, everyone speaks like apes. So it's all set in South London, very recognisable place, but instead of speaking, everyone goes, oh, 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 instead of using words. And it's kind of feud between a group and two families, and lots of filth and disgusting behaviour occurs.
What was the inspiration for this unique concept?
It just makes me laugh how much like apes we are, and I just took it to its logical conclusion, stripped away a layer of language, and sort of saw what happened. And it's all driven from me finding it funny. The main challenge was getting the language right, because I always knew it was going to be non-dialogue, but in terms of working out what that actually was, we did a lot of work with the actors on that, and we started off just pretending to be apes, and that was a bit too jokey, so we kind of broke it down and made everything much simpler, and eventually everyone found their level, you know, everyone came up with something slightly different, and everyone basically became an ape by the end of the filming. Yeah, amazing cast. We've got Toya Wilcox, Julian Rhind-tutt, Julian Barrett, Noel Fielding. We've got Tom Meaton, me, Lucy Honeyman, Holly Dempsey, Tony Way, Alice Lowe, and Shelley Longworth. I think that's everyone. Apologies if I've missed anyone out, but amazing people. I think the horror genre is all about dreams and nightmares, and you end up in a world that is familiar but isn't familiar, and it's a place of being, a place where you can be unsettled and scared and feel quite strange, and that's why it's a fantastic genre, and a very you feel very free when you're working within it, I feel.
For a particular horror film that had a big impact on you?
Well, Island of Lost Souls, my favourite ever, because Island of Lost Souls is the, I think FrightFest is the equivalent in festival terms. FrightFest is the Island of Lost Souls, because it's an island where loads of weirdos live and do strange things to each other.
Do you have any other projects in development at the moment?
Yeah, there's a script that I'm working on at the moment. It's another dystopian, strange sci-fi comedy, which is making me giggle a lot. It's a bit too early to speak about, but hopefully next year we'll be making that.
You obviously had a lot of fun making this film, but what are you hoping an audience takes away from it?
I hope they laugh a bit and find themselves slightly unsettled. And I made it to entertain people, and it makes me laugh, and it's a film that I would like to see. So maybe it'd be nice if people enjoyed it. Hope they do.
Can you tell us where your character fits into the film?
I play the mother of the lead female character, but I'm also an alpha female, so I get through four husbands in the film. And the film is very much about status and caste, and within the film, you're either an alpha person or a beta. The betas end up dead, and my character's alpha.
Tell us a little bit about perfecting the ape language.
The ape language was very much, for me as a singer, not a problem at all, because I know how to work with syllables, I know how to work with my primal body, as it were, and I found it very, very easy to do it.
I'm Lucy Honigman, and I play Denise in Aaaaaah. Denise is a beta ape, so she's on the quieter side, technically, or probably more like an introvert, if apes were introverts, or could be introverts. And she, when we meet her, she's a bit sad, a bit disaffected, a bit frustrated by life and the family, the community she lives in. And she's curious and wants an adventure and to break free in many ways. So she gets that wish. So basically, we play ape-like creatures. We look like people, but we are apes for all intents and purposes. And it's about communities living together and basically, there's kind of a Romeo and Juliet in the ape world love story that happens, and concurrently there's a big dilemma between the alphas, and a new alpha comes into the community with kind of outrageous things happen. And the challenge for me, well, I was cast 10 days before we started shooting, and all the other actors were on board, I think, for a year or so. So I got the job when I was on holidays in Berlin, so I kind of spent a lot of the holiday ordering an ape, trying to find my ape, and so that was fascinating. So that's a challenge, but even then it was just the script that Steve, this beautiful nuanced script that Steve wrote in English that we end up aping, was just the funniest thing I've ever, like, hysterically funny. So it was like a pleasure, really, and everyone's gorgeous and wonderful and, yeah. Wonderful. Everyone, there was not an ego in sight. It was, you know, like, we shot this in 2.5 weeks and everyone just, I don't know, banded together, and we shot it in Steve's house, and it was just, it felt like a big family, a very strange ape-like family. And it was beautiful, yeah.
What's Steve like as a director?
Kind and leaves you alone in the best way. He lets you kind of work it out and he helps you shape it without being, you know, I don't know, it must be hard for him because he's in it and he wrote it and he directed it, so it'd be a challenge, but I felt very at ease the entire time, so it's great. Well, I was saying before, Chucky, I always loved Chucky. Something about his weird skin. Something fun. I don't know. I kind of like those weird old 80s puppety things. Kind of like the throwbacks. And I like Ghostbusters, but I don't think that's horror. I think that's just... But I got scared with the ghosts and stuff.
What else are you working on at the moment? Where are we going to see you after this?
Well, I just moved to London from Australia some 3 days ago, so recovering from jet lag. And a couple of things that are airing. A political comedy and an Australian show we just finished shooting called The XPM. So that should air soon.
You've got a message to fans about this film and why they should make sure they go and check it out.
Because it's beautiful and strange and funny, man. It's really funny and scary, but in a not traditional horror way, I think.
What does it mean for you to be a part of this year's festival?
Oh, I can't put it into words. But then the entire film is not in words either, because we just make monkey noises. Very exciting. Steve did an amazing script. And we've gone from a script to a single camera in his flat all the way to Leicester Square to the Fright Fest. So it's an amazing journey. It's great.
Obviously, it's a unique concept for a film. Can you talk about your character and embracing your inner animal?
That was quite a challenge. We were chatting a bit after Steve wrote this amazing script about how we might make it into a new meta language, and how we might find that. And then he decided that it might be a good idea if I tried to play this alpha male. So it was quite an exciting and also funny journey to see if we could really embrace that and enter the monkey psyche. The biggest disappointment about this film is that you don't get to see the fantastic script that Steve wrote. I've been pushing him to try and bring out a version with subtitles so you can actually read the words. But it was actually a great shame not to say those words, but it was also a brilliant exercise in trying to find a different way of communicating, and it makes you concentrate on other aspects of the acting, which was fascinating. Amazing team of people. I haven't got any words to describe Julian Barrett, except a genius. And I did a bit with him, that was great. And of course, Noel as well. Toya was the first gig I ever went to as a child. And then suddenly I'm working with her in South London. So it's been a brilliant group of people. Every now and then you get a great alchemy of people who come together who are all really great. And we had a great time, so it was very enjoyable. Currently unemployed, actively seeking work. Nothing very exciting. Maybe Steve will make another film and I'll get a job one day.
Obviously, we know what Steve can do in front of the camera, but what's he like as a director?
Not great. Bit moody, bit difficult. Just tediously talented and his same old unstressed, calm presence. And of course, he's a genius actor, so he has a perfect eye for that. And he gets all the right people, so that looks after itself. So it's been brilliant.
Are you a horror fan yourself? And why don't you like horror? And why do you think other people do?
Not a big fan. totally scared and have big trouble watching them. But I like the psychological aspect of horror rather than the scary, strange faces that look like dolls. So delighted to be here, but won't be going into any of the screenings of any of the scary films.